about you, but my school can get a little insane. Yeah, we got a situation. Most of us stay up all night, and all of us think that we'll live forever. If we survive graduation, that is.
Thanks.
What are friends for?
Blood is family. Blood is pain. And blood is death.
Has been out for a little bit now, but just the other day, Rochelle Bruner very nicely asked if I could go back and pick it up and review it, and I know a couple of people have been asking me about it, so today, while I had some extra time, I wanted to share my thoughts on Vampire Academy. I have very mixed feelings about this. I saw the trailer in theaters in front of Mortal Instruments, which I ended up liking that film. I ended up liking Mortal Instruments, if you've seen my review. So because I was so surprised by that, I'm trying to give these kind of teen angst romance genre films the benefit of the doubt. So Vampire Academy is lucky that I didn't review their trailer before I saw Mortal Instruments. So I'm torn here. On the positive side, I think the creative team behind this film is phenomenal. The Waters brothers are very talented, specifically when it comes to depicting teenage women, and just women in general, actually. Mark Waters directed Mean Girls and Freaky Friday, both Lindsay Lohan, the heyday of Lindsay Lohan. And Daniel Waters very famously wrote Heathers, and also Batman Returns, which is one of my favorite films. I really love that depiction of Catwoman, and Michelle Pfeiffer, of course, did a fantastic job playing the role, but the sequence where she turns into Catwoman is amazing. And in fact, it was something that we watched in film school. I just really think that's a good movie, and largely due to a really good script. So that makes me feel that there's probably some real potential here. However, on the negative side, I'm getting increasingly frustrated with the fact that these movies make no effort at all to be cinematic. I mean, I this looks like a CW movie to me. Now, of course, a CW television show, like television movie, I guess. Now, of course, Mortal Instruments did too from its trailer, but it ended up, I felt, being very cinematic when I saw it in theaters. But I don't know. I mean, this movie, Vampire Academy, seems to have, like, soap opera lighting, three-point lighting. It's just so crazy to me, and I don't quite understand why someone can't take a little bit of extra time. As I mentioned with Kick-Ass, you know, these aren't budgetary concerns, really. It's just, you know, a choice. This is purely a choice. That's what it boils down to. Taking a few extra moments to do an interesting lighting setup and put the camera in a more interesting area. But you know what? Maybe nobody goes to watch Vampire Academy for beautiful cinematography and directorial choices. You know, maybe it's all about biting dialogue. I see what I did there. Biting dialogue and snarky characters. And I know for a fact that these two guys can deliver in that area. So I'm more curious about the popularity of these books. This trailer is doing very well online. I think that's fascinating. Mortal Instruments didn't do well in theaters, but its trailer never, I don't think, had this kind of viewership either online. So are you a reader of Vampire Academy novels? How does this look to you? And does it bother you if it's not cinematic, or is that the last thing on your mind? Do you just want to see these characters brought to life on the big screen? So write your thoughts down below. Thanks, Rochelle, for asking for my opinion. I hope you enjoyed this trailer review, and you can watch more right now.